So am I still waiting for this world to stop hating? Can't find a good reason, can't find hope to believe in.
Unprecedented success. For example, the movie 명량 is watched through 10 million viewers. How could it be possible? Our team wants to know the attractive elements of South Korean movies.
Turn up!
For Interstellar, I enjoyed the movie because the movie's theme was space and the director was Christopher Nolan, which I am a big fan of him. And for My Love, My Bride, I enjoyed the movie because I liked the actor, Shin Min-ah.
I think my guilty pleasure, I often watch a lot of action movies and sci-fi. If I have a lot of free time, I do like to watch more kind of art house or foreign films, but traditionally, usually, I often just watch kind of more exciting movies. Well, I saw Gone Girl. It was more of a thriller, actually, but very intense and very surprising. It's about a husband and a wife who have marital problems, and the wife gets kidnapped. But it's very kind of twist and turns, very shocking in the ending.
I watched 제보자 last month. On Chuseok, I watched Tatcha 2. It was the highest ranked. A house of doctor. So I think it's interesting, so I chose it.
Recently, I watched the Hang Gong-ju. Hang Gong-ju is the name of main character. Usually I like indie films, so I usually watch art movies or documentary movies and so on. And Hang Gong-ju is not mainstream. I'm attracted to that kind of movie. I like non-commercial movie. Moreover, I try to watch the movie that award a prize in film festival because it means the movie that just pursue fun. That kind of movie have artistic value. Hang Gong-ju award prize in many international film festival. So I think it will be good. So it was very good.
Turn up!
Although South Korea's movie's theme is very narrow, but the detail of the movie is very good. So that is the main reason.
In my view, war movie could be success, but comedies could be fail, because the possibility of Korean situation. I think war movie has a joy to the eye, and it is interest the people widely in the interworld.
I'm a murderer, and that movie was kind of, you know, in the same way, it had lots of twists and turns, you know, a very big surprise ending, and you know, I kind of felt very affected by it afterwards. So I think if I had to choose a Korean movie that was similar to that movie, I would say that I'm a Murderer. I think American movie watchers are very interested in foreign films these days. Well, there's certainly a group of, there's the big blockbuster movies that, you know, do very well, but there's also a lot of art house movie theaters, kind of smaller movie theaters that do play a lot of foreign films. I know, like, people like my parents, and even for myself when I lived in the United States, is I would often go to those movie theaters and watch films from other countries. So I think there is a very big interest in, you know, consuming other countries' culture. I think people are interested in Korean culture. I think that people don't understand it very well. And I think that people would be, you know, if a movie tells you something about Korean culture, I think people might be interested in watching that. You know, you really get to see Koreans interacting with Korea. And I think it's maybe not a realistic look at Korean culture. You know, it's very intense. You know, these characters are, you know, quite violent too. But I think that when you get past that, you get to see how Koreans tend to interact with each other, you know, and kind of maybe in a way that most Americans don't get to see it, you know. And, you know, a lot of our other exposure to Korea is things like Psy and, you know, K-pop. And, you know, it's a whole different side to Korea looking at Old Boy as looking at, you know, Gangnam Style.
Yeah, totally different.
Right. But both are interesting to look at.
They talk about the high classes and high classes rule the lower classes, and lower classes people blame about it, and they fight with the high classes, and the lower class won eventually. So I think the foreign people like that theme. And I think Korean movie will explain about Korean costume and Korean stuff to foreign people too. I think that the movie will identify the Korea.
I think Korean movie can succeed in foreign country. Indeed, unlike many Korean movies and Korean directors are get credit for cinematic quality. World is more and more unified, and people can sympathize with culture and sentiment. So, what we express, something like feeling or situations, can be understood by foreigners. And they can be impressed in Korean movies.
Turn up!
You think, like, you know, if I watch a movie now, or if I watch it 20 years ago or 30 years ago, that because the audience has changed, it changes the meaning and the feeling of the movie. Yeah, I mean, certainly. I mean, even for me, you know, watching movies as a child and watching movies now, you know, not only is that changed, but also my personal mood, you know, like, sometimes I'm in the mood for something silly and fun. You know, I'd like to see, you know, oh, I don't remember what the Korean name is, but 300 Pounds of Beauty about, oh, it actually had Kim Jong-un in it, but, you know, about a woman who had plastic surgery, and there we go, yeah. But, that movie was not a deep thinking, serious side of, but, you know, I really loved that movie. It was so much fun, and, like, you know, I got to see that part of Korean culture. But that said, sometimes I want, you know, if I'm feeling more serious, I want a more serious movie. I want a movie that, you know, shows me something real, something, you know, how people act with each other every day, or, you know, like Ajoshi, or something that's very intense. You can certainly find, you know, Korean people and Korean culture can be very fun and outgoing and silly, you know, like Psy and, you know, watching Running Man or things like that. But it can also be very serious, you know, when you watch the old dramas, when you, you know, I mean, you know, looking at, you know, recent news coverage, you know, America's been fascinated by the Sewol tragedy as well, and kind of looking at that side and the pain and the agony that Korea experiences, you know, that's more of the side of Old Boy. And so I think, you know, to understand both sides of that coin, you have to see not just the fun, silly, you know, YouTube videos, but also, you know, the serious movies and even documentaries, I think, could be very, you know, well received.
Of course, I think so. Because most people who make one movie is belong in this country, and they try to catch the what can be interest for fun, for many people, and it'll be reflect in movie because movie girl want to identify with character in the movie.
Turn up.
고무신이라고 생각을 해요. 우리 고무신이 우리 한국인이 신던 좀 전통까지는 아니지만 그런 신발이잖아요. 한국 명화가 가장 한국의 정서도 잘 담고 있고 문화도 잘 나타내주기 때문에 한국 명화가 고무신이라고 생각합니다.
한국 명화가 실제로 일어난 일이나 사람들에게 감동을 주기에 우리나라에서 가장 적합한 영화라고 생각해요. 있거든요. 그래서 한국인들이 가장 잘 공감할 수 있고 교훈을 받을 수 있는 그런 영화가 아닐까 생각해봅니다.
한국 영화의 가장 큰 특징은 관계적인 이야기를 많이 하는 것 같아요. 미국 영화를 보면은 개인적인 일대기에 초점을 맞춰져 있고 개인의 홈리즈 일이 많은데 한국은 사랑하는 사람이나 가족 그리고 친구들에 대한 이야기가 많이 있어서 그로 인한 감동을 많이 끌어내는 게 한국 영화의 가장 큰 특징 같아요.
Nowadays, globalization is one of the most popular issues. So Korean movie also built its own unique qualities. In this documentary, our team discovered the competitiveness of Korean movies, but maybe there are more elements than what we found. Those competitive power could be changed with different direction in the future, as viewers